Hello everyone, Gabe here, PC community developer here at Ubisoft, and welcome to our first video of 2020. We're starting off the year in a pretty awesome way because we had the chance to talk to some of the smart people over on the Rainbow Six team about some of the work they've been doing to implement the Vulkan API to the game. But because that's the exciting part, let's not delay any further and let's get to it. So what exactly is an application programming interface, or more commonly known as an API? In its simplest form, it acts as the middleman so the game can give commands to your graphics card so things actually appear on your screen. As you provide some sort of input through your mouse or keyboard to the game, it is then read by the API that translates that into a list of commands. All that is being done within your CPU, so there's a lot of things going on before anything reaches our graphics card. But that's just the start of the work, because that list of commands created by the CPU is then sent over to the graphics card, who processes what will appear on your screen. At a very basic level, this is the collaboration that your PC's hardware, the rendering API, and the game are going through to bring an image onto your screen. In a game, the performance you get is primarily driven by your CPU and your GPU. The two are running in parallel with each other, and your maximum frame rate is determined by the slower of the two. While there are things that you can do on your side to impact performance, such as adjusting in-game settings, at some point it will end up being limited by either your CPU or your GPU. This is where the API comes in, as it can offer different features that allow developers to enhance workloads and performance. So why Vulkan then? Rainbow Six is currently running on DX11, or DirectX 11, and as solid as it may be, it's getting up there in age, and it doesn't give us access to some of the features available on graphics cards. Plus, it's also pretty CPU intensive. You've probably heard of a few different APIs, such as DirectX 11 that we just mentioned, DX12, or OpenGL. Different APIs will give you access to different features on the graphics card. With a few options laid out on the table, the team looked at both DX12 and Vulkan, but after internal tests resulted in better performance on the CPU side using Vulkan, it was the option they ended up going with. Implementing it in Siege meant rewriting a lot of the low-level code of the graphics engines that is sending commands to the graphics card. This means that the fundamental ways of making things appear on the screen need to be rewritten with a new graphics API in mind. So in short, it was a large undertaking, but the team knows how crucial performance is to make sure that you can get the best out of your hardware. Plus, we all know how precious every single frame is. Using Vulkan, the team will be able to make improvements on workload through dynamic texture indexing to reduce CPU cost, and dynamic resolution and async compute to reduce GPU cost. So what does this all look like in Siege? Well, to start with, in 4.3, the team will be implementing Vulkan on the live PC servers. It's been through extensive testing internally, as well as a few outings on the test server, but now it's ready to go through the biggest test of all and put it into your hands on the live servers. This will allow the team to see how it performs on a broader variety of hardware on a much larger population to ensure its overall functionality and stability. Keep in mind that this is all a work in progress, and the team will continue to tweak and test, so you may end up seeing no change or potentially a decrease in performance on the initial release. The end goal remains, of course, to improve graphics performance for everyone. So with all of that, let's jump into some technical goodness and talk about three features that Rainbow Six is going to take advantage of to improve workload performance. Firstly, we have dynamic texture indexing, render target aliasing, and async compute. Dynamic texture indexing helps reduce CPU overhead by issuing fewer draw calls. A draw call is a call to the graphics API to draw an option that will appear on your screen. This, combined with your graphics card dynamically selecting the textures used in the shader, will result in less pressure on the driver and more CPU cycles freed up. So those of you that are CPU bound should see better performance and more consistent frame rates. Render target aliasing allows the team to implement dynamic render scale on PC, which dynamically adjusts the scaling ratio depending on the GPU workload. You'll be able to choose a target frame rate, and the game will automatically adjust to the render resolution to reach that target. This should result in more consistent frame rates for those of you that are GPU bound. Finally, we have async compute, which is a hardware capability that allows the team to execute tasks in parallel on the GPU, providing more tools and opportunities for better and improved optimization. Before we wrap this up though, there are a few important things to note if you want to give Vulkan a shot on the live servers. Firstly, ensure that your graphics drivers are up to date, as the team has worked closely with Nvidia, AMD, and Intel to optimize driver performance. Secondly, unfortunately, some older hardware is not supported under Vulkan. Check out the blog post for more information. Finally, GPU memory oversubscriptions, or requesting more GPU memory than available, can trigger stuttering and potentially crashes. To make sure you have the best experience, make sure you pay attention to the estimated memory consumption in the graphics settings menu. You'll also receive a warning whenever the game detects oversubscription is occurring. Thank you for watching, everyone. We hope that gives you a bit more information about what implementing Vulkan in Rainbow Six means. As always, if you have any questions or comments, you can leave them down in the description below, or you can reach out to the Rainbow Six team directly over on their channels, which you'll also find in the description below. But until next time, see you later.